It's one of those things people don't like to talk about. What happens in the toilet?
Irritable bowel syndrome is a terrible condition that afflicts about 10% of the population. People have diarrhoea, constipation, alternating diarrhoea, constipation, pain, bloating, wind. There's sort of secondary symptoms of headaches, backaches, restlessness, urgency to go to the toilet, incomplete evacuation. Generally, a whole collection of symptoms that people don't really like talking about but make their life quite a misery.
But for 1 in 10 people in the UK living with irritable bowel syndrome, talking about it is one of the best ways to cope.
Don't be shy. You know, everyone's got the same bodily functions and sometimes it just goes wrong. So don't be embarrassed to talk about it. The more you talk about it, the more other people are going to talk about it. And then the stigma and the, say, taboo of IBS will hopefully be overcome.
29-year-old Tamily Butterton has lived with the condition for 8 years.
My bowel habits had changed to the fact that I was just going to the toilet all the time. And some days it could be 8-9 times a day. But it took 6 months to get the courage actually to go to my GP and ask for some help. And when I actually got there, she was actually very nice. And she did a blood test. And then that came back normal. But then she referred me to a gastroenterologist who did several tests. And they all came back normal, which was a big relief.
Whilst Tamily was pleased not to have cancer or Crohn's disease, she was diagnosed with a lifelong incurable condition, but one which cannot be seen under the microscope. Like thousands of other sufferers, she sought help from the Gut Trust.
There's no cure for IBS. The best that people can hope for is to manage it, and there is a lot of ways of managing it. You can look at your diet, look at the role of stress. We focus very heavily on self-management. There is drugs you can take. They don't seem to work particularly well. Some people find some of the complementary therapies help, like hypnotherapy or acupuncture. Some people get really desperate and try really inappropriate therapies, which cost a lot of money and don't help at all.
Good girl.
Everybody has different symptoms. Nobody's exactly the same. Mine is predominantly diarrhoea based, where I get stomach cramps. Often, like with the pain, I hyperventilate to the point, you know, where I have to go to hospital. You know, the pain is that bad, you know, and I'm like, I've just got to get some help, you know, because it's just agony. And other times, it can be the constipation, which is I don't find quite as bad, but you still get the abdominal pain and everything. So, and the fatigue that goes with it as well, the after effects, it leaves you feeling weak and tired. So you just think, oh, I can't do anything. And sometimes I'm that tender after like a bad bout, I can hardly walk and I'm like this, I can hardly stand up.